Welcome to tutorial 2. Hello everyone and namaste. Welcome to tutorial 2. So today I'm gonna teach how to make the CRUD application using AdminLTE. So let's see what we have. We have this code which we have done previously, and if you are in the tutorial 2 directly, if you are directly jumped in the tutorial 2, please I suggest you to see the tutorial 1 and then you will understand what's going on with this code. So here we are in the main section, and let's see the okay. So this is the file and this is the main section. So first of all, open the git bash, or you can open the command here. So let's see, we have jump running or not. Jump is running properly, it's running properly. So php artisan serve, let's see what we have done. Okay, it's serving. So go to here, and this is just a template. This is from the template. Look here the index. So this is from the template. So here localhost. Okay, let's see what's going on with this code. We have the Laravel and I think admin panel. Okay, so from this URL we are logged into the in panel, and they here is the logo. Logo is not supported because we haven't done it so far. So first of all, what I want to do is I want to make the CRUD. So I'll make a simple CRUD called anything like the gallery or main box. No pages. So profile not found. So here we are. Okay, if you have up and running on this, then what I need to do is I need to clean up this mess first, from which we can make the CRUD. Okay, so from here, not from here, from the main dash, from this main file, this index file, you can see the UI element here. What are the UI element, what are the buttons, what are the slider, what we need to make the CRUD. Okay, so I want to do what I want to do is I want to do the layout options fixed. We have already the fixed navbar. We have already the fixed navbar, maybe. Yeah, okay. So what I wanna do is I wanna want to make sure, okay, so let's start to make the CRUD. So from here, let's start. We have all in the main.blade.php. So for the easiness, just do it like we have the head, we have the body, we have this navbar, and we have this main slider container. So we have the wrapper, we have this footer and these all the things. So what I'll do is I'll make the new file, file one called head. Sorry, head dot blade dot php. So other file will make like foot dot blade dot php. What I'm doing is I'm just arranging it. Okay, so here the other called the footer dot blade dot php, the other thing is header dot blade dot php, and the last one I want to do sidebar, sidebar dot blade dot php. Okay, if you want to make navbar, you can make it. So from here let's go to the main file, and this head, just copy this head, just copy this. Everything in the head, just copy it. So okay, so I have got it. Okay, just got this head and put it into the head, save it. And why here you can, what you can do is you can do include it, include that file from website dot backend. So we have to give the path, this is the path which we have given, website dot backend dot layouts dot head. So this is done, this is not done. So here in the here we put, okay, we put here. So we have the body, we have the navbar. If you want to make a navbar also like that, you can do it. But what I am doing is footer. In this footer I'll just go and make this footer, just got it, and here include website dot backend dot layouts dot footer. We will do it. So let's go to this footer. So let's go to this footer and paste it here. So in the foot, what we can do is we can just copy this, all the script things, all the script things, you can just copy it or cut it. I will cut it and include it, include website dot backend dot layouts dot foot. Okay, so go to the footer, foot, and just paste it in there. So this one is done. Okay, so we have the sidebar, sidebar. Let's see where the main sidebar container, we have this sidebar. Okay, so here all the sidebar is here. So just copy this sidebar, or I have told you, you can cut it, include website dot backend dot sidebar website dot backend dot layouts dot sidebar. Okay, So when we put this slash sidebar in blade templating, what will happen is it will automatically recognize that, oh, this sidebar means sidebar.blade.php. Okay, so you can just, okay, so in the sidebar we need to paste it in the sidebar. So let's see, it is going in the right path or it's going in the wrong path. Refresh it. Okay, website backend layouts head not found. So are you sure it is a blade.php? So let's see, is it right or wrong? Head.blade.php not found. I think we have done the two times, so it's not working. Let's delete this again, copy this new file, head.blade.php, and paste it and save it. Save it. Let's see what we have done. Let's see what we have done so far. So this had been made, head.blade.php, and let's again do it. Okay, so it's not working, right? So it's not working. Website backend dot layouts dot head not found. So what I want to say is, you will got a lot of problem like this, and what you need to be sure, you have to see these things, this not found. So in Laravel 6 is the very lovely things had done, and that is this, they will show the probability of what is not found or what. So don't be so much, oh my god, what is happening now. Don't be like that. Just be cool and do it. So here is website backend layouts not found. Okay, so let's see there, what's the problem then. So this is not the project. So let's see there, what's the problem then, what's the main problem, what's the main factor, and you can just look at it. So the problem is, I found the problem. The main problem is, I used to do the website first. I used to first make the website and then backend and layouts. That is why that the habit, that was my habit. So, but here is backend and layouts. But what we have done is, in the main file, we have given the path, and that is the website also. So just clear it out. We have backend and we have layouts. We have backend and we have layouts. Okay, backend and layouts. So everything is done, right? Oh, here also. So okay, got it. So the most important thing is debugging. Don't stuck on the debugging. Just see, be cool and see the debugging things. So let's refresh this. Wow, we have got the browser. Okay, so we have got this, right? We have got this. Good. So what I want to do is, I don't need this these things. So AdminLTE, I need this logo and this AdminLTE written it. I don't need this. So let's clear out everything which we don't need it. So let's clear out it. Go to the sidebar. Sorry. So let's see, if you don't need anything, just go to this the here, and you can just see from by inspecting it, this is the main, it's the loveliest thing, you know, it's the lovely thing. I have just done this strategy, so this okay, this is in the this UI li, and this all are the navbar, you can see by this. Okay, so what I need to do is I need to get all the, I don't need these all the things, dashboard 1, 2, 3, I just need only one. So for now, just delete this. So user panel, I don't need this image for now. I don't need this image for now. I need the info. I wanted this info for now, but just for now. So I don't need this this image too, this image too, I don't need this image too. So okay, right, and I'm just commenting it. Okay, for the comment, just do CTRL plus this one. Okay, plus means you have to just press the CTRL and this button. Okay, done, not the plus button. Okay, so let's comment it. I don't need this L, this dashboard, I don't need this, I don't need this also, and only one. Okay, just I need only one, I don't need this, I don't need this, I don't need this, I don't need this, or I don't need these items. Everything in here, I don't need this, all the kind of things. I need this. So li, let's go to all the things ul. Okay, so let's go here and just comment it. Okay, and see what will happen in the code. Okay, let's see. Okay, that's right, everything hasn't vanished, right? So I don't need this dashboard also for now. So just for the main dashboard, what I need to do is just inspect it, see which is the main content page, content wrapper. So is this the content wrapper? Okay, first of all, just delete element. Okay, that's great, content wrapper. Okay, just what you need to do is, so here let's go to the Laravel. Okay, just go here. So what I am doing is I need you to see the documentation also, that is very much so good here. Blade template, okay, extended template, blade template extending, and this and that. Okay, so I'm trying to make you, so here you have everything you need to do. So for now, what I'm doing is just blade template yield. So so these are all the about the documentation. Okay, so go to the section. Sorry, so here what you want to do is, you have done this, you have to go to the main section and then content wrapper. You found the content wrapper, that's great. So content, header, container, and everything, we don't need these two things, right? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna either delete it, or for now I'm doing this main content and content header, everything I have done it, like everything is okay, everything is gone right now. Okay, so we have the blank page for now. Okay, so now what I will gonna do is we have the blank page, and here let's start to make some view controller or some one simple CRUD. So let's start one CRUD. So the CRUD name is, so let's start one CRUD. So before that, before starting the CRUD, what I wanna do is so before I want to start to make the CRUD, let's see what I can do. So which I have commented this, I just need to open this. Okay, so we have the class content and just comment this one only. Okay, so let's see what will happen. It will not happen anything, I guess. So it's the same, right? So in this content section, what we'll wanna do is we yield. So here we will blade L content sections, label blade snippet here is written. It is all because of this which I have done, this extension which I have done, and it will be easy. So here I will write content. So what will happen is it will bind the other page. I'll show it later. So we have done everything, right? Everything has been set. Now let's start. Sorry, close this. So let's start. What I want to make is I want to make, right, contact. Okay, contact. Contact, right? So let's start contact. So I want to make the contact, personal contact, or the personal portfolio, something like that, profile, anything. So personal information or the contact. So first of all, what you have to do is I want to make sure to make those things, right? So what do you have to learn, or you have to keep in mind, go to the step wise or step by step. So first of all, this will help you in every project, right? So for making, first of all, think about the model or anything you want to design in database, and then after you make the model, go to the database, go to the database, okay, and after that think about controllers, and after that think about route, and at the end the view. So this thing you have to know. So let's do it step wise. In every step you have to think it. Okay, so I'm gonna make some personal or contact. Okay, so PHP artisan make model, right? Make model. So for now I'm making personal contact, right? Personal contact, and doing minus m. So what this minus m do is minus m makes the migration file, okay? Minus m makes the migration file. We don't need to write the PHP artisan make migration and the migration name. This will bind the model in the migration file, okay? So personal contact means what will happen in it will go in these sections. It will stay in the app sections, like users inside the app, it will go this section, okay? But if you are to make models, if you want to make this models, then models make one folder and go to the models section, okay? So for the good view, you can just use this models to make the new folder. Let's see, and let's make the enter, okay? Then what will happen is it will make one folder called models, okay? And then here is the personal contact, and it has been already binded, okay? And then the second thing I want to do is means here you can see that personal contact, it has been made, personal contacts has been made. Here you can see that, right? So the other thing I want to do is go to this personal contact section and just write the table name. Means you have to make here a column, right? And it will automatically goes, if you are using SQLite, it will automatically goes to the SQLite by migration or anything, MySQL or anything. So for this, if you are confused in the table, you can just go and see in Laravel. You can just see in the getting started, right? If you are confused in what are the things, so what the Laravel gives, you know, about the all the database configuration, from configuration to all the things, you can see here, okay? So this is another, so this one, so let's make it, right? Maybe I am doing it in the slow process. It is because I want to make you understand, and I am giving you the chance to do it like what I am doing it. You can do side by side, okay? That will be help you a lot, and that's thing that will help me a lot too, because I am trying to teach here a Laravel. And please, for my channel growth, you can like, subscribe and share as many as you can, okay? Table. So what this table means is, from this table, okay, in this table, which is the personal contacts, this is your table name, right? You have to know that schema create the table name. If you are already familiar with the database, then it is okay. If you are not familiar with database, so this will be our table name, and from here it will this will be all the columns, okay? So let's start from making name, okay? So string name, so string or integer, these are all the things you can see in the Laravel documentation. So in name, if you want to make it null, then you can use nullable, okay? If you want to use null, if you don't want to use null, just do it like it, okay? Table, so name string, I'll make a string, email table string form. And table string one image, okay, or picture or photo or profile, anything you want, right? Image. So I have 1, 2, 3, and 4 things, okay. I have name, I have email, I have phone, I have image. So if you want to make some default, sorry, for image I'll do it text, okay. It's a long text, it will be sometimes it will be long text. So if you want to make it like default or make it defaults, you can just use it from DFULT default, and you can just use anything in this. But for now I don't want to make it. So what we have done is we have made the model and we have used the migration things, okay. So let's go to the model again, and here what you can do is you are calling through the model, okay. So you have the calling, you are calling the table through the model, or you are connecting through the model, okay. So here what you can do is protected fillable equal to, so make an array, just name email what we have in or what the data we want to receive and make or create, etc. So info name email image and other, what we have other, phone, right, phone, okay. So this thing's done. So we have made this model, and what I have said before, after we made the model, let's make one controller, okay. So let's make one controller, php artisan make controller. Let me repeat you, php artisan make controller to make the controller. So controller name personal contact controller. So these things, why I made this, this is like this is not the mention as we have to do it like the controller, no, this is not the thing. But what I used to do this because to make it easy, because it's the control of the personal contact, so personal contact controller we usually write. So here the thing is, what the magic in here is, we can just use it, the double dash and resource. What it will make it, it will make the resource of a controller. I'll show you. So what happen is, go to the HTTP controller, and here is our personal contact controller. So in this, this index, create, store, show, edit, update, destroy. So these all things comes if you write this resource, right? If you write this resource. So what the resource will make is, resource will make this index, create, store, show, edit, etc. things, okay. So we have got the controller, we have got this. So after this all the things, what I want to go to is, first of all I want to go to the route. So I'm typing here web, but you can go directly by, you can go by searching this. Here is the route. In the route folder we will find the web. So this determines the path, right? This determines what? This determines the path. Just learn it. This determines the path. So here we have done, what we have done is when we go to our path, and then we have go to slash admin panel, then the function calls the view, which is back in layouts main. The functions called the view, which is back in layouts and then main, right? So this thing is done, right? So the other thing is route get and home slash home equal to home controller index name home. So what is going on here? If you go to the home, right, then home controller will call the index. So these things look like messy, right? Sometimes it look like messy, but let me clear it out. It will make it, this is the home controller, means this is the home controller. I want to make you sure this is the home controller, right? The route is calling controller first. 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 Controller first. And the in the controller, @ index means the controller function. So let's see in home controller. We have this index return view home. So route is calling the controller index. The controller route is what the route is calling? Route is calling the route is calling the controller index. Okay, I think you have done the great job. So let's make another right route, and then the great thing Laravel does is resource. Yes, so you ask resource. So it what it will make is, so for this slash admin panel slash, and what we want to do is we want to make the phone contact, right? So what you want to make, we can name it anything, but I'm writing it personal contacts. So what it will do is it will just, we are just making it resource a personal contact, and then I want to make personal sorry person contact controller only this much, right? I am not calling any, you know, I am not calling anything. Oh my god, what's going on? I am not calling anything. So you may be confused, he is not calling anything, but here in the upper it has been calling this one. So don't be so much confused. Here is the route get and then home, there has been called only index. So that's the magic about resource. We have put it already, the resource. Okay, so we don't need to call this index file. It will be automatically, it will be automatically generated. So for this we can just see here php artisan route list. Okay, just you can see this, it will be helpful for you. So the personal contact had been, it is automatically created personal contact. So the personal contact @ store this means, so it has been. So what is the name in the upper side? We have the name home, or we can, it's like route get, and then we have admin panel, and then personal contact, and then we have personal contact controller, and at the rate index, and name it. So name will be used to define the route. I will show you later. Name personal contact dot index. So these things has been automatically, we have the get and we have the set. So these all the things has been automatically made by the resources. Okay, so you can see here, sorry, I have just caught it right now. Oh my god, sorry. So you can just see here PHP artisan route list. So it is happening because we have already this. So what I want to show is this means so this the first thing means the get personal contact and it's @ index personal contact dot index. So you can see it. Let's make the index file. First of all, what happened is if these things happen, and then we are going to call it. So we have made this, we have made route also successfully, we have made route successfully, we have made this model successfully, controller successfully. So what will be the index? So in index we can call return view so in the view file we just I want to make one folder called, okay, folder name is just want to make one for personal contact. Okay, and in the concurrent I will make three file, a dot blade dot so these files, other one called update dot blade dot php and other called index dot blade dot php. So I have made the three files, a dot blade dot php, update and index. Okay, so let's go to the controller. So in the index file what I want to show is in the main file when I go to the personal contact, what I want to say is I want to show the backend dot personal contact dot index. Okay, so this is the thing, but we also have to bind the data, right? I mean to say we have also have to bind the model. Okay, so for this I will to make data equal to personal contact. No, nothing is happening. personal contact. Where is it gone? Personal contact all. So is it working or not? So what I want to do is there any problem on that? Personal contact controller model, where is our model? Personal contact. But why is it is not showing there? So let's go to the controller homes. Go to the personal contact controller. Okay, so here what I want to do is personal contact, and then I know why it is not working as usual, but what you wanna do, personal contact all. So what this thing is doing is we are calling the models. So if it is not calling, that's why sometimes I don't like this app. So use app okay, models, and personal contact. So we are using this personal contact. So when this thing is done, remember to throw this data or send this data to the view. Okay, so for that what we will do is compact and then the data, call the data. Okay, we are sending this data variable. Okay, so these things also have been done. Okay, and then this is done, this is done, everything is done here. Okay, so only index file is done here. So what I want to make is everything is done in the index file also done, but I want to make the main file. I want to go to the main file and I want to make here, let me see. So I want to make one sidebar. Okay, so this will be called this general. I just want to make like only one nav. So you can so I'll just copy this one. You can copy from anywhere, but you have to copy from this AdminLTE. Okay, so I'll just tap copied and I'll just paste it in which section? In sidebar section, right? So I'm pasting it here and I have just made the name called the contact, personal contact. So let's see what's going on here. Okay, we have not loaded the file. PHP artisan serve. So we have here the personal contact. So for this I have to call the route. So route list will, so what I will be doing is I will be calling, so this is very helpful, double brace, very helpful here. So what I'll be doing is I'm doing a route and I will be calling personal contact dot index. So it this will call to the controller index. Okay, this controller index. So it has already made by the resource. If you want to see the resource, I've already told you. You can go to the terminal. From here also you can use terminal. Just see here. PHP artisan route list. So what we are using? We are using these things. You have to know that we are using these things. Personal contact dot index means the contact controller address index. Okay. So these things we are using. These all the things. Okay. These all the things we are using. So let's go to the. Okay. These things have been done. Okay. After that, what you can do is you can just refresh it. You can click here. Maybe you'll get an error. Okay. So the thing is, the database had not been found. So let's see. This is up and running, right? Jam control panel is up and running, and you can use MySQL here. You can see the MySQL. We have everything. So it's getting late. Okay, so we have all the database will be here. So I don't want to show this, so I just have to. Why it is happening? Because I just want to show that it is all because we have done the great thing. Yeah, we have done the great thing, but the thing is we haven't migrated, right? So we have not migrated this table. So if you remember in my previous session, just let php artisan migrate. Please remember that I am using this Visual Studio terminal. I have already this terminal up and running. I am using this terminal because I don't want to, you know, I don't want to close that. So php artisan migrate. So it has been migrated successfully. So what I want to do is I just want to refresh it. I just want to see if it's working or not. So let's see. Let's refresh it. So view backend dot personal contact personal contact dot index not found, you know. Sometimes it's one of the sometimes it happen only by doing this, but let's see the error, because without error we will not learn. Okay, so let's see what is happening here. So index personal contact, so this is the thing, this is one of the error. Personal contact, here is I have written it CNTSCT. So spelling mistake. So let's go fast forward. So everything is done, and again refresh and refresh. Okay, everything is came out, but nothing is came out really. Everything is came out, but nothing is came out. It is all because we have not done some minor things. Like, let's go to the index section and let's extends. So what this extends do is it extend the page. Okay, let's extend the backend dot layouts dot. So please don't be confused, backend in view, backend outer of the view, it doesn't matter. So you just have to give a path inside the view from the view. Okay, backend.layouts.main. I want to say that, hey, the file, come here with me, come in the index file. Okay, and let's refresh it. Oh wow, we have got this right. But in here we have to do the personal, I mean to say, we have to do the personal things in here. Okay, so for this, let's go to the admin. This is just a template, okay, HTML template, and let's see the in anything here we have which we need, like a table, right? So we need a table here. So where's the table? Here is the table, single table. Okay, so we need a table here, right? So this type of table or anything, any table you want to do. Extra, no, where the stat of table and data table. This, so I want this table, right? I want this table. Inspect, I just want this table. I need this table. I definitely need this table. Totally. Just copy this. Okay, you can just copy this. Okay, copy this section. Just cut it to see the try to run. Date element. Yeah, I add this table. No, I need this file only. I need from here only. I don't need anything. So copy this element and just delete this into C. Okay. Okay. So I have copied that element. Here is the great thing about the Laravel. So here section this, and here is the section content. I think we have named it content. So what these things gonna do is, in the main we have used this L content, and this means we can use that in this internal file, we can use the extended file. Okay, so in the index sections, you will know that by doing this. Let's see and refresh this page. Refresh it. No, this page refreshed. Let's refresh this page. Okay, we have got this right. We have got this, but it's not the main thing, main page. So what we are going to do is name, email, and then image, and then we have all the things. So let's go to the, I just forget that what was the model. So I want to see name, email, image, and phone, right? Name, email, image, and phone. Just learn, just name, email, image, and phone. Just go to the body, these sections. So let's start connecting everything you have. So what we need is, we need only one row, right? We don't need this all kind of things. We just need a only one row. So let's start doing it. TR or TD for the table, right? So sometimes if you get confused, you can just see from this table things and just inspect it. So it will be easy for you to know where is this coming from, like th in the tr role row th, this all coming from the tr th. Okay, so this all coming from where? You have to know the th, right? The th. This all coming from here, right? So just paste it, make it enter, just enter it. So I'm going through the scratch by which you can learn easily. So th, we have the, we don't need this all the things now, but if you are a designer also, you can use it, all those things. So I am just doing it. Okay, I think these things are in computer. So what we need is we want to have how many things? Name. We want to have name. We want to have email. We want to have name, email, phone, and we also want to have description, right? Image, right? So we don't need this. Okay. We don't need this. And I don't think we need all those things. Just delete it. Let's see. Okay. Okay. Name, email, phone, image. So name, email, phone, image. So we don't need this TH again. TR and TH again. So I don't need this. Let's refresh again. Sorry, so we have two columns going on. I don't know why it is not like being the let's create everything. So let's see here, refresh the page. Okay, where is this A coming from, man? Just delete this A for now and just refresh it. Okay, now it's right. So we have name, email, phone and image, right? So for name, for this what we can do is, so let's see this. We need a row in everything. Okay, so what we can do, we just say for each, right? For each, for each, you know, I'm here doing the loop, only for each loop, right? Start for each and in the loop in after the tr. Okay, because everything we have to do the, you know, the row. Okay, So what we can do here is, for each, and here the first thing what you have to do is the data. This is the data, right? So this data we will be calling in index data as, so I'll write info. Info, right? So info, and then info is here, okay? So, and here the thing is, this double curly brace is the very much great, lovely and sweet thing. From here you can just show what the user want to see the information. So this one, this curly braces are mustache, what you want to say. This is the very best thing. So it is easy to connect the data. So info, so from info it is fetching the name, right? Again, if you want to render this, okay, from info it will fetch the what are the those all the things, name, email, phone and image, okay, name, email, from info it is fetching email, and from info it will be fetching phone, and from info it is fetching image. So for the image I will tell you later. So for now everything is set, right? So let's go and see the page again. Okay, it is not showing anything, means we don't have any kind of image, okay? So what I want to make is, in the index file I want to make the three things more. I want to add three things more, which will be like add, update and delete. So is there anything called bottom here, UI element, bottom icons, anything? So let's go to the mod bottom, this type of button. So edit, so I want to make one edit button. So copy this element, and just go here. Paste it here and just handling this, okay. So I also want to use this button. To add. Okay, so I will just go here and make one TD more. So and use it like, okay, another button. And one we need to delete, okay. for this, I think, delete. Maybe it is. Delete. So I use this button for delete. Maybe I hope it will work. So here delete, here add, and here. So everything is set. So for this, what I have to do is I don't want to use it. I just need to use the this has been made okay successfully. So for the add, we have to go to the create section. Okay, so to create, what I'm just copying this and pasting here. So we don't need data for now to create it, because we just want to show it only. So what we will show is it. Okay. So what happens is return view back in personal contact head, and this head will call this head. Okay. This head. So here also just copy this index file head. So if you make one type one thing, then it will be easy for you to make other things like card body, other things. You can just copy and paste for the entire sections and use whatever you wanted to use. So for now I am using this content this. Okay, so I want to make sure that this and this this also bottom, this bottom I want to use this bottom also. So I want to use this button to add the sections, okay, in the other form. So let's go to the index. So I want this one offside here. Okay. So and I will call it add. Okay. So let's go to the and here you will see the button will appear here add. Right. So I just then looks good, I think. Make sure it will be, it will not be like this very huge. So for now it will be okay. It is visible, but also if you really want to, you can just use this TD. You don't want to use this TD, you just want to make sure that it will be how much. So for now let's it has been done. So in the index file, in the add file, so what we have to do is, right, in this add file, what we have to do is, like, we have to make one in the bottom called the add, then, so a half a anchor tag. So a half equal to, what we need to do is we need to call the route again, right? Route, if you are guessing right, then it will be personal contact dot create. By clicking this, what will happen is, just to refresh this page, by clicking this add, sorry, I haven't closed the add tab. So by clicking this, what will happen, we will go to the add sections or the create sections, right? And we have already made the boilerplate on that. So what we need to do is we need to make a form, right? So for here, form general elements, you want to do this. Okay, this is the perfect for us, I think. Quick example, inspect it, copy it, and just paste here. So simple, right? Paste it. So simple. Just change here name, email, type text, so file input is here, upload is here, so I don't want these sections. To do something, this is for image, right? So other thing is, I need this, check it out, whatever this is, I need this, so I need this division. So we have name, email, phone, we don't have phone here, right? Just make the phone here, phone, and then name, email, phone, and then so here is the placeholder, so you can place it, enter name, email, phone. Okay, done, right? Name, email, phone, and these things are okay. So what will happen is, after this, let's see here in the create section. Oh, it's coming or not? Oh my god, yes, we have everything. We can just enter name, email, phone, and just input, and just do something like this, and you can just upload it, right? You can just upload it. So for now, what I'll be doing is, so for now what I'll be doing is just everything is done. Quick example, see here, form role, right? Hit the submit button, hit the form role, everything is here, is done for now. So in the input, just to make sure that input name is name equal to name, so this will bind to the data, right? So email, so name equal to email, this will bind to the data. So phone, name equal to phone, so input and all the things. Okay, so input type, so make the name equal to image. We want the image, right? So image. So everything done, right? Everything is done. And hit the bottom submit. So in this form, other thing I want you to do is, I want you to make sure that the two, three things. First of all, so I want to make sure that this method, sorry, not this method, method equal to post, we have to make sure that. And another thing, this type equal to that. Okay, just make sure these things mainly this method post. So what is the post method? Post method is we are sending the data from the users or the from the view to the database. Okay, so for this we have to use this post method. And in the Laravel, if you do only this, it will not do anything. Okay, so for that we have to use CSRF. Okay, CSRF token, because it will, CSRF means it will, it is a token, right? So it will be very helpful. You can just read about the CSRF. So for now, the other thing I want to do is, so these things have been done here. So let's go here. Let's go to the link. Let's go to the let's go to the phone number and just choose one file, anything. So you can just go to the pictures, just choose any file from here and the submit. Nothing happened. It is because why the nothing happened here from here. Okay, so it is because we just have done everything only here. So it is not calling anything or anywhere. Okay, so we have to call it, right? Action equal to, so what we have to call it, we have to call it route, and personal contact dot stored, right? So you can see from here, I will open the terminal again. So PHP artisan route list. So what will the store do? So the store one, personal contact dot store, means it will call the personal contact controller, the function called store, right? At that store. So let's go to that function. Let's go to that function, personal contact controller, right? Controller. And in the store, what will happen is, let's see, you can just see from here what data is coming. So data is coming in this request. Just remember, data is coming in request. Okay, so I'm doing it. So anything, so let's do this and submit. So let's see what will happen. So the post method is not supported for this route. Support mode is get, head, put, patch, and delete. Okay. So what it is saying that post method doesn't support in this route. So for this, what we can do it. So we'll go to that route. Okay. This is store and add here. So everything is right here. From role and the post, and we have also given the CSRF token. So what was the problem? So I think there is some problems in the form. So I have put it a new form, deep class form group row, and input type file, and class form control h auto name image. So we have put this name image. So what happened is when we put this name image, it will just take it name phone name. So let's go to controller. I have some bunch of code which I have already done. So after that, what will happen is when we just let's go here after this. So Rohit or anything. So admin@admin.com. So AB, sorry, phone number, just type some phone number random, and in image just take this image. So before I go to the submit, once again let's see the get file. So what we have the get file, just recheck it. Form role form, it's just a form. So action, in action we are going to call the personal contact dot store. So this is the route we are going to call, means personal contact dot store. So we are going to call this store route. Okay, so after that let's see other things. So these all the things. So we have bottom, and I have just changed this image. So you can just see this code from here. Okay, you can just see the code. Okay, so let's and then what will happen after you submit the button. So in this store section, so in the index section, create section, went to the air, and in this store section, before I go to this, which I have done the bunch of the code, before I just say I will do DD, it means it just for the what is the value coming. So let's go to this section. So I have done all this. So let's submit button. Okay, what will happen is you will find the thing. So where is the, so you can see the file array. So here is the array. So this token is called the CFRF token. So this is because this is the token. So for the secureness, the token has been this. That is why we always put the CFRF. We always put the CSRF token. Sorry for my voice, because of the common cold, it's been like that. So phone, we have the phone email, everything is here, right? So I want to do this. So first of all, I make one variable, and I have done this dot request image, means, and it goes to the extension, and request image move public path image. So what it will do is it will move the image to public path image by using different name, right? By using different name. If you are familiar with the PHP, you can just, you know what does it mean, but if you are not familiar with the PHP, then you can just use this code. So request image move public path image show. What you have to do is, if you have not done, you just have to just see that in public image. Okay, so here is the image. The image is in the public. Okay, so it will automatically create the image, or you can just create new folder in the public, right? In the public. So it is the path basically. So another thing is personal contact means, then what will happen is personal contact means this is the model. Okay, create, it will create in the area, right? In the area name. So this is the this name and this name, there is difference, right? In this name is the this email, this phone, this image is the database column name, okay? And this one is the request name, means request email, request phone, means request. It will, it is coming from the request. So this request coming from this head, okay? So this is this one. So this name, name, email, phone and image. So if you understand this, what will happen, it will create, if this is this function is called, it will create and then return, redirect to the router, okay, with a success message. It will not show the message because we haven't done, but return, redirect to the route index, okay, return, redirect to the route index, okay, return, redirect to the route personal contact index. So it will return the to the route. Let's see if it is happening or not. So let's go to the section. Let's see here. Okay, just refresh this, continue. Let's see if it will redirect or not. Okay, it is redirecting, right? I think here is some error, it hasn't done. And this is the add, this is the edit, and this is the delete button. I think it's gone bad. So here is the name, email, phone and this image. So this is not showing the image. I will show you how to show the image, but first fix this. Let's fix that. So in the index, let's fix this. Okay, so is it good or bad? I don't know. Let's delete this span too. Let's refresh it. Okay, so it doesn't showing anything, but here is the delete. Here is the delete. So add, edit and delete. So here also what we can do is, we can just go to here also, you can just if you want to add new, just you can use the A class button, yes, from here also you can add, right? So what you can do is, you can just say route, and if you remember, yes, personal contact dot create, and it will call the create. It will be in this form. Okay, everything is done. So let's refresh it and click the head. Route it. So here the spelling mistake. Just CNTSCT contact. So again, go to the page. And again, yeah, it's coming. So you can just go here and just click here. Yeah, it's done. So the other thing is image. So it is showing just the image number. So for this, what we have to do is, for the image, let's make one. So img src equal to, so let's make this, okay, so width equal to 100, width equal to 60 pixel, height equal to 50 pixel. Let's need this. So these things I am doing in different way. See, at AS we are using asset. So asset will call, what we call asset? Asset will call the public, okay? So image, right? And we're using dot, and this is the info image. And what will happen is, in image, it is calling the that folder. So let's refresh this page. It is coming out. Let's refresh it. So it is not showing this. Maybe there is some mistake. Image dot info. So what we have to do is, like, after the image, okay, not in the image, after the image. So let's refresh it. Yeah it came. Wow, yes, it happened. So for edit, we have edit. Now after that, we have to use this edit options, okay? So for edit, what we can do is, we can go to this controller first of all, and in edit we can just use, first of all what we have to do is route. First of all, we need other things, right? So data equal to, we data, what we need is, we need all the things, like, no, not like, we need all personal contact, all right. So this is the thing we need, okay? So return view backend dot, what we have in the backend, personal contact dot update, right? So what we have to send is compact. We have to send the data, okay? So it will call the update page. It will call the update page. So it will call the update page. So update, just copy this all and paste it into the update, okay? Paste it into the update. So here what we'll do is update. So let's go to the so edit means it will just show the page, okay? And then in update we'll do all the things. So for update, what we will do is, let's start. So before this, let's go to edit first. So let's see what is happening here. it is taking all the data, but in edit we need only the one data which we will edit. So what we'll do is we'll make one find. So and in find what we'll go want to find is ID, right? So what this will do is it will only take the main and the master ID, okay, and it will be easy to throw data. So let's go to the update section. So here what you're gonna do is you are going to update, but what we are going to update is you have to do some ID, any ID we have to what we can do is data and ID. So we are going to update the file in which this ID will come, right? This ID, this data and this ID will come, okay? So this ID is from the database. We are going to update that in ID, okay? So maybe you are feeling so bored, man, what time is gonna take? So this is the first time, so you will feel bored. So I suggest you to take a coffee and just pause the video and again start the video. So first of all, you have to understand that in update sections what we need to put is we need to put also, okay? So method put, okay? So this is because we are using the resources, right? So we have to use this method. And if you want to know more about this, you can just go to the Laravel documentation. So this data is, comes from this data, okay? So this is the variable compact data, and this ID. So here is the ID comes here, and then what will happen, this data will come to, so in here, how, from where the ID will come, I will show that later. Just finish this update section first. So data ID means the ID of the database, okay? So in name, so we have the data also. So just put the data here. You can use anywhere value equal to data. How is the data? This way, data name, right? I'm just copying the whole thing and just pasting here. Data email, data phone, and emails. Okay, so it's done here. Okay, everything is done here. So it is because to see the value, okay, when you just edit. So how we'll get in this the here, okay? How we you will get this page? We have added this update page, but we haven't added this A in the index page. In the index page, we have used the A route, okay? But we have to use this edit route also. So for this, just half equal to. So here's the thing, we need to use the route, and personal contact dot edit, and what we need to pass is we need to pass the this info, going to pass this info, ID, okay. So when we click any one info, so the just pass this ID, don't alter the ID. So it will say that this info ID, and then what will happen is it indicate the same things ID, okay. So let's go here, let's refresh the page, okay. Let's go to the edit section. Yeah, we have got everything, name, email, and everything, okay. Just I am doing this, but if you I will submit, it will not happen anything because we haven't done anything in the controller. So what we have finished is we have, when we clicked the edit button, it will go to the edit and pass the ID, okay. And then what will happen is it will show the, and this will go to the edit, okay. So this find, this is found and made to this personal contact update, in update and then data, it is compact. And then what will happen, it will show this page. After that, when we will submit, what will happen is it will go to the update section, because in this update we have used route personal contact update data ID, okay. And in update section we have used another one thing called the method put. So and everything is here, data email, data phone, data everything. So this data has been fetched by the here it is, so don't be confused, right. So let's go to the update section. So let's update. So for that I will use one, okay, data variable again. So and then what I'm gonna use is I'll use personal contact model, and I'll find that ID. What will happen is it will find that ID which I have passed through this data ID, okay. So it will match the ID. And then other thing what I will do is just go to the op sections and copy this, okay. Copy these sections, this section. And just paste this section here. So what I want to do is I will just call if, okay. So if the request if the request has image, when the, this is the object section. So if the request has image, you know, if the request has, it's so easy, right? If the request has image, I understand my point. If the request has image, then what will happen is it will go there, and this will make it. And again, another thing here, what you can do is you can just use data image equal to this image. So what we are going is, this is new thing, okay. Data have image, so this data means the personal contact we have ID, okay. Data image. So one thing we can just use data and name equal to just request name. So it is disabled nowadays. Data email equal to request request email data phone equal to request phone. Okay, everything is done. Okay, so this has been done, and at last data save. So this is the things which save the so this is things which saves the database. So return redirect. You can just use the route, okay, like here route. Person contact dot index. Okay, you can just use this. Okay, return redirect person contact this index. So this has been done. Okay, so let's see it is working or not. So what is the data means? This data means the personal contact, and it will find the ID. Okay, if you really want to see, you can see by using the DD. So I will just go here, I'll just read back, just edit this page. Okay, something is error, man, there is something error. So you can see here there's something error. It shows maybe there is something which make it error. So what is that error? We have this right, we have this, we have beta, we have this save. If request has image, everything is right, I think. So let's see what it is showing. Unexpected. So this thing is unexpected. So where it is unexpected? Maybe here. Seriously, maybe it has the unexpected or you can use here. Okay, let's go there and check it out. Is this the unexpected data save? Is this the wrong thing? So maybe this is the error, right? I think this may solve our problem. So let's refresh it. Yeah, it was the error. So change it to omit. Submit the file. Okay, done. Omit, name omit. Okay. Yes, so we have updated successfully. Again, if you want to update the mobile number, let's update it, man. Wow, successfully done. We have still done the job. So let's add another one. ABC. So let's use some image here. Okay, let's submit the page. I'm showing it because I want to know that we have two data. If I will delete one, okay. So in this delete button, you can just use it read or anything else if you are good in CSS. So when we click the delete button, what will gonna happen is we have to use the delete. Okay. So these are the things. Okay. So in the delete, I have a bunch of code which I have done it, and I will elaborate it also. So actually delete is very easy, and to use this destroy function, you know, the destroy function. Actually, there is something we have to change it in the index file. Okay, so to use this delete, to use this delete, what we're gonna do is just look at this code. So we are clicking this button, right? So before that, just what I have to do is make one form. Okay, form. Form action equal to where we'll use the code. Okay, so this will use the delete, sorry, this will use the route. Okay, route, and then we'll use person contact dot destroy. Okay, so what will happen is we'll use the method also, method method equal to post. Equal to post. So we are near the end of this. So method equal to post, and then what we'll gonna do is we will gonna make sure that we are using the info ID. So we have to delete by using the ID, right? So these things, just close the form here. So just close the form. So now let's go to the, so another thing what we're gonna do is we're gonna do make one CSRF here, and other thing what we're gonna do, method, we'll make method delete. Okay, so everything is done here. Let's go to the controller form. So if you normally want to destroy, just use one data variable equal to, and just use personal contact, and I need the ID. So ID, sorry, ID. Another thing what you are gonna need is just data equal to data. So we have the delete method, delete method. So it will automatically delete the thing. Okay, but we don't need this way. Okay, because we need to unlink the image also. So for that, what I will gonna add some code, just like file and unlink, so those kind of code. So I'm gonna add some code. Okay, so let's go and add bunch of code. So image is data. So what's going on here? Let's see. So image means data image. So we are getting the image from data image. Okay, okay, done. So file path we are getting from here. Okay, So main image means file path and image. Okay, so here I will do the image path. Okay, so if file exists, image path unlink the image path. Okay, so this is the bunch of code which I have added. You can see here, and maybe if you are using the PHP, if you are a previous PHP developer, you will know the code, right? So let's see if it is working or not. So before that, we have to again, after we deleted this, we need to return redirect route. Personal contact dot index. Okay, so I moved I have done this in the slow motion so that you can understand this whole things. Okay, so let's see. Just refresh the page. Let's see if it is working or not. Oh my god, here is some problem. Maybe there is some thing which I have just updated in the index file. Oh, gee, there is O. Right. Let's see again. Is it going good or bad? So let's delete this page. It happening? Nothing just happened. Nothing happened, right? Nothing happened. It is because we are using this form and this route and method post, and we are closed this form. I think in action bottom also we need to use. We need to use this. So I don't need this A class button. So I just need this here. Okay, let's do it. And I need to remove this A. So let's see, it will happen. It will be, it is going to work or not. Does it delete? Let's see. Did it do anything? No, it doesn't do anything. So let's again try with another thing called the harf equal to. So I'm trying to make this like, you don't be confused in the distro section. If it was the delete, if we made the other things, it will work, but for this sometimes it doesn't work. So I want to make you the concept clear so that you will not be confused. So let's refresh the page again. And what happened? Oh my god, oh my god. Oh, we have used this bottom. So let's refresh it. Okay, let's refresh again. Let's see if it's gonna work or not. It is not working, right? Yeah, that's the thing, it's not working because it's calling only one. Let's refresh from here. It didn't work, right? Let's put the method delete here. let's put the method delete here. Let's again retry it. Let's again delete it. It's not working, right? So what I want to say is, for the delete, so we need the form, okay? We need the form type. So what we can do is, so for this, what you can do is, you can just use this into bottom, okay? Sorry. So bottom, and just delete these things from here. Delete this thing from here because we have already done it in the form. Sorry. So let's refresh this page. Okay, and let's delete it. And what happened? It is successfully deleted. Okay. So we have done the add. We have done the edit. And we can just delete it, and it's gone. Let's sum up. Finally, we have created the CRUD. We can just add, update, and delete. So from here, it's your call. You can just do anything you want to do. Okay. So you can just dig in, and you can just make the CRUD, and you can make the other things, like you can make the CMS, and if you feel little, you know, bored, or if you feel that, oh my god, it's little hard, then you can just use this. I will upload the code, and I will link the code below, so you can just see the code also. I'll upload this whole project. And by the way, please don't forget to subscribe, like, and share, by which I will get motivated, and I will do more on this kind of topics, and I will do more on IT topics. Thank you very much. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you.